So in this video, we are going to explore the standard form of a linear function. We're going to do this in different ways. First, we're going to interactively explore and see what the values mean. So in other words, which values am I referring to? I'm referring to that m value over there in front of the x, the coefficient of the x, and then I'm referring to the c value. So let me just write it over there. Y is equal to mx plus c. We are going to change to this equation. I'm going to change the m values, the coefficient of x, and we're going to see how that affects our graph. And then we are going to change to the c value and see how that affects our graph. Now, just going back, thinking about the previous video, where we had a function, we had that, and we had to complete the table, and we had five coordinate pairs that we could plot. And I told you that I know that that is going to be a straight line when we plot those points. And the reason how I knew that is because that function took on that form. There we had a coefficient of x, which is m. So my m is 3, my x is to the power of 1, and then we are subtracting something from it there, in this case 2, and that would be my c value. When it takes on that form, then it will always be a straight line graph when we plot it. Okay, now let's investigate. So over there, we've got y is equal to mx plus c. There in the orange block, it will show you what our gradient is, what the m is, and then there at the end, it would show you what the c is. So let's start by changing to the coefficient of x, that m value. When we do that, so now my m is 1/2, now my m is 0.7, so that is my gradient, my steepness of the graph, or the slope. So the bigger my m value, the bigger that coefficient of x is, the steeper the graph would be. Okay, those are all positive gradients. If we make it smaller, then obviously the gradient would also be less. Let's see what happens when our m is 0. It falls flat because 0 times x is just 0. So then there would be no gradient. The gradient is 0. So it's like when you're running hills, when you're running flat and there's no hills, it is smooth sailing. There's no gradient. Let's change. Oh, we first need to make the gradient 0 before we change to the c. So see what happens when your gradient is a negative. There we go. We've got a negative gradient. Positive gradient, negative gradient. Positive gradient, negative gradient. And the deeper into the negatives we go, the steeper it will be. There we've got a gradient of negative 2. There we've got a gradient of negative 3. Okay, let's go back to a gradient of, say, let's make it 2. 2. Let's change to our c value, the value that we are adding or subtracting there at the end. If I make my c, there my c is 2, 3. Can you see that every single time, if that's 5 there, it cuts my y-axis there by 5. If I make that 4, it cuts by 4. If I make it 2, cuts by 2. If it cuts by 0, then it means my c value is 0. So it moves the graph up or down. If my c is negative 1, it will cut by negative 1. It moved 1 unit down. And if my c is by negative 5, it would cut by negative 5. So there's our summary. Our coefficient of x, our m, affects the steepness of the graph, and how bigger it is, the steeper the graph would be. And then our c value is our y-intercept. It's where our graph cuts our y-axis. So what we just saw, let's just quickly come and write this down. We can identify in an equation that it will be a straight line if we were to plot it and draw it when it takes on this form. I've got my y is equal to m is being multiplied by x, so there my coefficient of x is my gradient, the steepness of the line, and then the value that I added or subtract to that, that would be our y-intercept, where our graph cuts. our y-axis. That gradient, nobody would be able to read that. Sorry. Gradient. That is a little bit better. Okay. There is our standard form for a straight line graph. Let's do these four examples. There we are asked, rewrite the following in standard form and identify your m gradient, coefficient of x, and see what we add at the end. So let's go and do that. Well, this one isn't in standard form, the first one, because we need y by itself. So we can easily do that by just taking that over or subtracting 3x on both sides. Whatever I do on the one side, I must just do on the other side. So I get my y by itself, and now it is in standard form. There is my m, my gradient, the coefficient of x, and there is my c, my y-intercept. So in this case, my m is equal to negative 3. It's a negative slope, and my y-intercept is by negative 1. So it will cut my y-axis by negative 1. So I'm just quickly going to make a rough sketch of what that would look like, more or less. So it would cut my y-axis by negative 1. So if negative 1 is there, if my gradient is negative, it tells me about how the direction of the line, if I can put it like that. And negative 3 is quite a big or quite a steep gradient. So I think that straight line would be something like that. That's obviously just an estimation and a skew, but it's good that we're starting to visualize that. The second one, it's not in standard form because y is not by itself. In order to get y by itself, we are going to have to divide the left-hand side by 2, but then we also have to divide the right-hand side by 2. So then we're going to get y by itself. That will give me 2x, and that would be plus a half. Be okay to work with fractions in this section. Let's identify our m, coefficient of x. There's our gradient. There's our y-intercept. So in this case, our gradient is 2. Our y-intercept is a half. If we try and visualize this, rough sketch of what this would look like, it would cut my y-axis by a half. So if a half is somewhere there, my gradient is 2. So it's a positive gradient, and you know, maybe something like this. Maybe something like that. Okay. Let's look at the penultimate one, the second to last one. It's not in standard form because my y is not by itself. So I need to go get my y by itself. Negative y is equal to negative 2x and take away 5. And doing that is your equation knowledge. It's still not in standard form because we don't want a negative there. We just want y. So I'm going to subtract by negative 1 on this side, because remember, there is an imaginary 1 there. And then I also have to do the same thing on the left. And when I do that, I am going to be left with y on the left-hand side. And over there, negative 2x divided by negative 1, which will just give me that. And then negative 5 divided by negative 1, that would just give me that. Okay, it is in standard form. Now we can identify our gradient, the coefficient of x, and our y-intercept, our c value. So in this case, our gradient is 2, our y-intercept, our c value is by 5. If we quickly visualize that, there is our y, there is our x. So it cuts by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up there. It is a positive gradient. So something like that. Okay, last one. Is it in standard form? Definitely not. We need the y by itself. So let's do this. I'm going to get x, and it's going to be 8 on that side. Still not in standard form. We need to divide by 4 to get y by itself. That is our aim. But then we also have to do it this side. Now with this one, we just need to be mindful what's going on over there. So pay attention. So those two would cancel out. We've got y. Y doesn't need to be on the left-hand side. It can also be on the right-hand side as long as it is alone by itself. With this one, we're going to land up with x that's being divided by 4, and we're going to subtract, so 8 divided by 4, that is 2. Then we can say, okay, but wait a minute, that doesn't really look like standard form. What is the gradient? Oh, okay. So let's go and write that. Y is equal to x over 4 minus 2. We can clearly see what the c value would be. There it is. But that other one is a little bit difficult to figure out. So quickly just track with me over here for our fractions. If I have x over 4, my coefficient over there is 1. But that doesn't mean that the gradient is 1. We can't just ignore that 4. So let's go write that like this. 1 over 4 times x. Because then we can clearly see what the gradient is. So that would be y is equal to 1 over 4x and take away 2. But why can we do that? Why does that work? Let's just think about our fraction knowledge. If I have 1 over 4 and I'm multiplying that by x, I can just write that as 1 over 4 times x over 1 when I multiply. How do I multiply fractions? I multiply the numerators and I multiply the denominators. So if we start with a half that is being multiplied by x and we do all the fraction stuff, then we land up there. It is the same thing. So when you have something like this, where we're dealing with a fraction over there, you can just rewrite it like that, where you clearly see what the gradient is. I'm going to do another example like that with you in a moment. So in this case, the gradient is 1 over 4. Our y-intercept is negative 2. Got it. Let's just do one more example like that. I feel like it's the right thing to do. So let's say over here, we've got y is equal to 2x over 3 and minus 1. Okay. There, we can clearly see our y-intercept. The y is by itself, so it is in standard form. But let's just go write this in a way that we can clearly see what the gradient is so that we don't say the gradient is 2 because the 2 is being multiplied by the x. We are going to take that 2x over 3, and we are going to write that as 2 over 3 times x. They mean exactly the same. They are equal to each other. They are just written slightly different. Okay, so watch out for that and don't let that confuse you.